Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in this session we will discuss the common PG entrance test for zoology 2020. So let's go to the questions. So first question is, amoebic dysentery is caused by, so the answer will be Entamoeba histolytica. Okay, so next question, Ecdysone is a juvenile hormone. The answer will be option D. So third question, in sponges, the cells surrounding the osculum. So as you know, the answer will be myocytes. So the option B will be the correct one. So next question, conchology is the study of, that is the cell of mollusca. So option C will be the right answer. So next question, syncytial epidermis is found in, so that is found in case of your Ascaris. So option B will be the right answer. So coming to the sixth question, Aristotle lantern present in, that is in case of your sea urchin. In sea urchin, you will find Aristotle lantern. So option C will be the right choice. So coming to the next question, it's a very easy question. So in earthworm, or direct question, in earthworm, the ovary is situated in, the answer will be 13th segment. Ovary is present in the 13th segment of earthworm. So next question, that is the question number 8. In cephalochordates, gill slits open into pharynx. So the answer will be, correct answer will be the A. So next question is about mammal-like reptiles belong to, that is the line, synapsid line. So option D will be correct one. So in the question number 10, the question is regarding fossil record of Archaeopteryx have been discovered from the Germany. So the option B will be correct one. So next question, that is the question number 11, largest living land animals are included in the suborder Proboscidea. Okay, so option C will be correct one. Next, question number 12. The driving force of an ecosystem. So as you know, solar energy is the main source of energy. So option C will be correct one. Question number 13. The term ecotype was coined by, it is Gottrusen. So option A will be the correct one. So next question, the term biocenosis was proposed by, it's a direct question. So the answer will be C, that is Karc Mobius. C will be the right answer. So next question regarding the limiting factor for the photosynthesis. What is, we need to know what is limiting factor. So without absence of that factor, your photosynthesis cannot be possible. Okay, so here it is asked this, which of the following is not a limiting factor. So the answer, correct answer will be option A, that is oxygen. So coming to the question number 16, receptor mediated endocytosis from plasma membrane requires which one of the following coat protein. So as we know, that is the clathrin coating is there. So the option A will be the correct one. So coming to the question number 17, it's a kind of protein, regarding the protein. The protein that is responsible for the sliding of outer microtubule doublets against one another to produce ciliary binding. So the correct answer will be dynein. So option B will be correct one. So next question, which of the following protein targeting mechanism is common for both mitochondria as well as chloroplast organelle? Okay, so in case of that is the mechanism, that is the post translation, okay, after translation, the step which is similar in both mitochondria as well as chloroplast. So the option B will be the correct one. That is the post translation. So coming to the question number 19, so it is about your cell cycle, control of cell cycle. So the cell cycle is controlled by, so the correct answer will be the phosphorylation of cyclin. So this will be the correct answer. Option B is the right answer. So coming to the question number 20. So which of the following biochemical reaction is most commonly utilized by living cells to propagate intracellular signals? Okay, that is the regarding intracellular signal. So here what happened, two correct answers are there. So according to my knowledge, so option B and option C both will be correct one. So that is the phosphorylation and methylation are correct one. So let's wait for the answer key from CPET. So question number 21. So it is regarding the semi-conservative replication. So there is a certain isotopes are used. So question is, isotopes used for providing semi-conservative replication of DNA are. So in the semi-conservative DNA replication, two isotopes are there. So that will be option number B, that is the N14 and N15. One heavy isotope and normal. The option B is the correct one. So next question number 22. In prokaryotes, the lagging primers are removed by. The lagging primers are removed in case of prokaryote by means of DNA polymerase 1. So option C will be correct one. So coming to the question number 23. When the human genome draft sequence was released, which of the following observation was least expected? So least expected. So all of are expected, but one option is that is the least expected one. So that will be the size of the total genome is the least expected one. So option number B will be the correct one. So question number 24, regarding the photoreactivation, when we go through the mechanism of photoreactivation, so in that case, it's a process which uses light to activate repair engine. Okay. So the option B will be the correct one. That is, it uses light to activate repair engines. Next question, that is the question number 25. It is regarding position effect. So the position effect is the result of mutation. So the mutation will be the correct one. Position effect is the result of mutation. Then question number 26. The perineurium is the connective tissue layer which surrounds the entire nerve. Okay, so entire nerve is surrounded by the perineurium. So option A will be the correct one. So next question, question number 27. The most important factor in determining the percent oxygen saturation of hemoglobin. Okay, so the answer will be the partial pressure of oxygen. So the option A, that is the partial pressure of oxygen, which is the important factor for determining the percent oxygen saturation of hemoglobin. So next question is the 28, that is regarding reabsorption of chloride ion from the glomerular filtrate in the kidney tubule is carried out by diffusion. So by means of diffusion, the reabsorption of chloride ion is there. Okay, so the option B will be the correct one. So next question, 29, question number 29. The gastric gland cell whose absence could lead to pernicious anemia. Pernicious anemia is the parietal cell. So by means of the absence of your parietal cell, so that will lead to a severe disease, that is the pernicious anemia. So question number 30, all the hormones of the adrenal cortex are synthesized from cholesterol. So the cholesterol is the precursor molecule for synthesizing the hormone which are from the adrenal cortex. So question number 31, it is regarding the primary target organ of aldosterone action will be the kidney. So kidney is the primary target organ of aldosterone action. So option C will be the correct one. So next, coming to the question number 32, it is regarding macrophage M13. Okay, so the question is about the genetic material of macrophage M13. So as your M13 macrophage is having the single stranded DNA, so the option C will be the correct one. Okay. So next question is a kind of numerical type. Okay. So what is the number of hydrogen bond? So it is regarding the number of hydrogen bond in B DNA of having 1000 base pair. So 1000 base pairs mean in the DNA we will have the 1000 into 2, that is the 2000 number of nucleotides are there. Okay, so with the proportion of the bases C, A and T in one strand of the DNA, in one strand, cytosine is the 60%, adenine is the 30%, and thymine is the 10%. So here we have C is equal to G is equal to 60%. Okay, so next, A equals to T, that is the 30%, and T in one strand, T in another strand complementary will be A, that is your 10%. So what happened? So out of that, so GC percent is the 60%, okay, and 80% is the 30 plus 10 will be the 40%. So out of 1000 base pair, what happened? So 60% means, that is the 600 base pairs are GC base pair, and 40%, that is the 80 base pair, will be 400. Okay, so when we calculate the hydrogen bond, okay, in the between G and C, 3 hydrogen bonds are there, and in A and T, 2 hydrogen bonds are there. Okay, so we can calculate. So 600 into 3, that is the 18 100 GC hydrogen bond there in between G and C, and in between A and T 40, that is the 400 base pair are there. 400 into 2 as in between A and T, two hydrogen bonds are there. So 400 into 2 will be, that is the 800. So finally we are getting 2600 number of hydrogen bond. So option A will be the correct one. So next question is regarding the DNA sequencing by means of Sanger method, or we can call it a Sanger sequencing. In Sanger's method of DNA sequencing, the growing DNA chain are terminated because here we are using one radioactive nucleotides which is incorporated in the DNA. So the option B will be the correct one. The radioactive nucleotides is incorporated by for the termination of the chain. So next question is, that is the glucose and galactose are two isomeric monosaccharides known as, so as we know, the glucose and galactose are the epimer. So the option B will be the correct one. So in this video we have discussed the from one question number 1 to 35. Since the total question paper consisting of 70 questions, so as the video will be longer one, so we will discuss from the 36 to 70 in another video. So thank you all of you. So thanks for watching the video. Thank you.